So we've been working in the Gulf of Mexico in relation to the oil spill. Some of the issues we've been examining are trying to understand what is happening or what has happened to some of the small organisms that live in the Gulf. In particular, we're very interested in what are happening to the organisms that live in between the sand grains. So before the spill, it looked like a typical animal community in terms of the small, what are called myofauna, that live in between the sand grains. And then after the spill, some of those same sites show a lot of fungal organisms and a big reduction in some of the other myofauna or animal type organisms. One of the challenges we have now is we need actually more time points to look and see how major of an effect this was, and if it is really damaging to the ecosystem, or maybe it was just a quick blip. We don't know yet. We need more data to try to determine this. One of the questions in our mind is, are these sites going to return to the way they were before? Or a lot of times when you perturb an ecosystem, it will return to a steady state, but a different steady state. And that could have implications for changing the whole ecosystem, the food chain, and ultimately how people utilize that food chain.
And our main objective is to study the distribution and the environmental transformation of oil in affected coastal wetlands, especially in the Louisiana heavy oil areas. We do know the oil persists in the wetlands, but we don't know how long it will persist. We know that because of oil spills, those bacteria respond and immobilize the heavy metal, but we don't know whether heavy metal will be immobilized in the future when the chemical conditions change. The impact on the wildlife, you can consider the immediate impact, as people see from the media. For example, those seabirds, the feather coated with oil, essentially they lose the ability to fly and regulate body temperatures. And you also see the mammals, the seabirds, ingested those oils, and also the dying and dead coral are found deeply under the sea. So those are immediate impacts. But we also need to consider long-term impacts. As I mentioned, our team has found a high elevated amount of oil still persists in the wetlands. But the long-term impact on wildlife probably would not be long for many years to come.